Good morning, Dr. Suhaili. And I am Sarmya Sri from Biomedical Science Department, and my matrix number is 183258. So my title of research proposal is The Effectiveness of Osimum Septum Leaves in Reducing Blood Glucose Levels in Induced Diabetes Mellitus Type 1 in RES. So my introduction will be about diabetes mellitus. It is a metabolic disorder categorized by high blood glucose level due to defect in insulin secretion, insulin action, or maybe not the insulin is not detected. Second, the poor control of this, what is being concerned of this disease is that the poor control of this condition can cause nephropathy, neuropathy, retinopathy, cardiovascular attack, and hypertension, and so many complications due to this. Thus, I want to introduce the always can be found in home plant which is called as Osimum Sanctum. It is from Kingdom Plantae, class Magnoliopsida, family Lemisiae, and genus Osimum. So basically, Osimum Sanctum is known as Tulsi by Indian, and it is usually found at Southeast Asian. And it is claimed to possess antiseptic, analgesic, anti-inflammatory, antimicrobial, immunomodulatory, hypoglycemic. Hypoglycemic is the one we are actually focused on. And according to Journal of Diabetes Research Volume 2013, Osimum Sanctum has bioactive constituents present in it, which are flavonoids, saponins, tannins, triterpenoids, basically all these biochemical constituents are actually very good for possesses antioxidant properties as well as hypoglycemic properties. Next, my problem statement is, in Malaysia, it is an alarming increase in diabetics in Malaysia. And it is increasing too rapidly year by year. And if you see here, you can see by it has increased about 3% compared to 2006 to 2016. This is 2016's data record. And according to World Health Organization 2016, the mortality due to diabetes mellitus only among all the causes that causes mortality is 3% for Malaysian population. So it is an alarming condition in Malaysia. So thus, what I want to justify here is that tulsi can even be planted indoor and it is easily consumed by Malaysian diabetic patient. Why not we use it instead of costly insulin? And it is a depth information of confirmation of tulsi hypoglycemic properties can help to curb the rise of diabetes mellitus patients in Malaysia as well as prevent the disease itself. So my objectives will be to investigate the effectiveness of Osimum Sanctum, which is also known as tulsi, in reducing blood glucose levels in diabetes mellitus in induced rats. And we can also, through this research proposal, can also confirm the hypoglycemic property of Osimum Sanctum. So my methodology will be divided into two parts. Part A will be extract preparation, and second one will be the experimental plan. Extract preparation includes the plant will be collected and the leaves will be separated. Second, the leaves are washed thoroughly to avoid any contaminant, any insects. After that, dried for under sun for 3 days. They are then blended into powder form. After that, 20 gram or 100% concentration of this powder Osimum Sanctum was prepared by mixing it with 20 ml of ethanol. Next, this ethanol mixture are sonicated for 1 hour. Later on, the extracts were extracted into petri dishes by using filter funnel. The petri dishes are left to dry completely. After that, 2 gram of dried ethanol extract is dissolved with 2 ml saline to have a concentration of 100%. So basically, all the concentration are 100% is being used here. Then next, my experimental procedure will be 30 30 rats are required to be sampled according to pilot study. So there will be 60 healthy subjects induced with diabetes mellitus, 30 male rats and also 30 female rats to actually block any differences between gender. After that, that 60 healthy induced diabetes mellitus rats actually divided into two groups, which are control group and also experimental group. In control group, there are 15 male and 15 females, as same as the experimental group, which has 15 males and 15 females too. Then the 30 subjects, which are the 15 males and 50 females in experimental group, are administered orally osimum septum every day 2 milliliter of 100% concentration for 30 days continuously. And the control group are given nothing every day for 30 days. And the blood plasma glucose level for both groups are analyzed and recorded every day 2 hours postprandial. And the data is recorded, tabulated, and statistical analysis was done. Next, the expected result will be oral administration of ethanolic extract of osimum sanctum leaves led to significant decrease the blood plasma glucose level in diabetes mellitus induced stress for about at least 50%. And then the osimum sanctum leaves were proved to have hypoglycemic properties as claimed. Then acknowledgement, I would like to thank UPM, Biomedical Science Department, Biomedical Research Faculty, and also my friend. Thank you.